Good afternoon, everybody. Today I'm going to show you how to install QGIS software on your computer. This video lecture is not going to be long because it is quite easy and straightforward procedure. So first of all, where you should go is to visit this qgis.org website. This is website of QGIS software where you not only can download some software but also discover more about QGIS. So here we are on the start site of this, the starting page of this website, and what is probably interesting for you is if you are not English native English speaker, you can also change the language of the website to the one that you really need. Well, for the sake of this video, I will keep the language to English. And what is interesting in this web page is, of course, also to get a little bit more information about the project of QGIS. So here you can see the menu on the app, discover on the upper part of the website, namely the options are discover QGIS for users, get involved, and documentation. So basically, let's click on the first one, discover QGIS. Here you will find some interesting information about QGIS project, community behind the QGIS project, and other interesting information. You can also browse through, you can see different applications of QGIS. What is QGIS server? So basically you can go through each and every of these bookmarks, and I'm sure if you are serious about learning GIS and remote sensing and you would like to be a profi and expert in using QGIS, you would find this information quite useful. We have also here map examples. This is very quite inspiring, and I would also recommend you to browse through it because it can give you, let me just click on one of the examples here. We can see some map. It looks like a topographic map. Basically, I don't know which language it is. Looks like Polish probably, or maybe Slovak or Slovenian. But anyway, as you can see here, we have a number of different examples of exciting applications of QGIS. This is, of course, is very inspiring when you just starting out with QGIS. Okay, let's move maybe to the documentation. This is the last one option here on the website, and basically also this is also quite interesting for you to look at it, because here we have such useful documents as a user guide, QGIS user guide, QGIS training manual, a gentle introduction to GIS. So basically different interesting materials and documentation which are directly connected to QGIS and which for us as the users might be important. Okay, this is just introduction to QGIS website, and now let me go to the return to the main page and show you basically how should we install QGIS. Well, here you can see there is two different buttons. One is download now and another link support QGIS. So basically download now, we can click it. I will open it in a new window, will forward us to the download QGIS platform where you can see different releases of this software. So here a few words about different differences in releases and versions of QGIS. Well, first of all, we have different differentiation of the QGIS according to the platforms that you are using. So let me make this small, and you can see that we have different options. So software available for downloading for Windows, for Macintosh, for Linux, and two more options for BSD, as well as you can actually test and run QGIS on a mobile device or tablet. I haven't tried it, but might work. So, since I'm a Windows user, I'm going to show you the installation for Windows. I'm sorry that I can't really help you with Macintosh or Linux installation, but I would assume they are quite similar and straightforward. Regarding a functionality of QGIS program software depending on the platform you use, this is a little bit different, and the interface could slightly differ from Linux, Macintosh and Windows releases. So I also have prepared all my practicals, as well as the videos that I have recorded for you, are based on versions for Windows. So you guys please consider this, that it might slightly be different from the version that you will use, in case you are not a Windows user but Macintosh or Linux user. So I again go to click on download for Windows, and here we have different options. We have latest releases options and long-term release options. So latest release options are those versions that are experimental. They are currently being developed. The new features are adding the bugs which are already detected in the previous versions are fixed. So basically those are the latest releases. What is nice in the latest release is that some new features could appear in those software, in this latest release software of QGIS, but at the same point the problem is that those versions were not tested as much as long-term releases, so they are not that stable. Yeah, so for my practicals and also for my teaching that I do, I always use long-term releases, because as I said, they are more tested, the bugs are known or fixed, and the interface is familiar, so those are more stable versions. And I also therefore provided you installation for a long-term release version. So here we will work with installation of QGIS installer version 3.10. And well, basically, if in a practical it was meant that the version is different, then it's not a big should not be a big difference. It might be a slight changes in interface, but in general, this is not a big problem if you install 3.10 version instead of 3.4 or 3.0. Basically, the versions they do differ a little bit the interfaces, but in general, some features or the basic features are remain the same. So then once you are here on this page and you have decided whether you want to download the latest release or long-term release, then you have to think what kind of machine you have. Is it a 32-bit machine or 46-bit machine? In my case, it is 64-bit, so I need this version. I click on it, and basically you can see that the downloading process is starting, and as soon as basically it's finished, you can click on it, and wait a little bit, and then the dialog window appears, which asks you whether you really want to start installing the software. Well, I click yes, and so I click twice, so I don't need it. Okay, so basically when you click yes, you will the dialog of window appear where you can start installing software on your computer. You click here next, and a license agreement will appear, which you can go through basically. and you should agree if you want to continue. Then the standard procedure, you have to choose where you want to install your software. In my case, it is often the same folders C on the disk C, program files, QGIS 3.10. Probably it is the same for you. You click next. Here the QGIS has an option to install together with QGIS the files, the data sets which could be used to, for training. Since I have all of those data sets, I would not include them in this video. So you just click install. And the installation process starts. You have to wait here some time, usually depending on your computer, but usually installation does not take us a few minutes to complete. And when the installation processes will be over, you will receive a message from QGIS. So let's wait a little bit. Basically, when the installation process are finished, you will see the dialog window which says that the installation has completed, and click finish to close this wizard. So let's do this. And after this, you can go to the to your Windows menu. Basically, I'm using Windows 10 computer, so if you use the same computer, it will be very similar. So, and as you see, on the top, you will see recently added files, and you will see QGIS desktop version 3.10.4 and the same desktop version with GRASS. I would recommend you to use with GRASS, for example, or you can simply click search and, for example, click on QGIS, and then you will find this. But since you can see I have different versions installed on my computer, you have to be careful which version you would like to use. So let's start with the version which we just installed with you, which is 3.10.4. I clicked on it, and you can see that as a long-term release, QGIS 3.10 is launching. And here you go. Well, you can the QGIS is opened. Here I have different projects which already were transferred from my older version to a new versions, and basically we can start using the new version QGIS for geospatial analysis. That's it. Thank you for watching, guys.